अच्छा अलग ऑडिट करें सके। ओके
मैम।
गॉट इट।
सर ओके
डिफेंस
ओके,
स्टाफ, थैंक यू वेरी मच गणेश कॉलेज सर।
थैंक यू सर।
टुडे एकेडमी ऑफ रोगनिदान प्रेजेंटिंग लेक्चर ऑन उपद्रव बाय डॉक्टर नैना विश्वकर्मा प्रोफेसर एंड एचओडी फ्रॉम गडहिंग्लज आयुर्वेद कॉलेज कोल्हापुर। आई वेलकम ऑल द रिस्पेक्टेड टीचर्स एंड डिग्निटरीज। स्पेशली आई थैंकफुल टू डॉक्टर वेंकटेश धर्माधिकारी सर, असिस्टेंट डायरेक्टर ऑफ आयुर्वेद गवर्नमेंट ऑफ महाराष्ट्र पुणे। आई ऑल्सो वेलकम डॉक्टर अतुल वार्षणे जी, ही इज अवर एक्चुअली ही इज पैट्रॉन एंड आवर मोटिवेश एंड इट और रोग निदान एसोसिएशन एकेडमी ऑफ रोग निदान प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द रोग निदान एसोसिएशन। I welcome all the dignitaries, especially I welcome Dr. Veena Kanti Madam, Principal of the Gadahinglaj Ayurved College, and all the participants. Today we are going to present the topic of Nidan Panchak, that is Upadrava. Basically, this is important regarding the prognosis of the disease and the treatment of the disease. Ayurvedic concept of the Upadrava is well elaborated in our text. Therefore, it is important in the also in emergency management of the disease. I am requesting Dr. Naina Vishwakarma Madam, please start your lecture. Over to Naina Vishwakarma.
The screen shared so he ne hote.
Okay, ma'am. Your screen is visible.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay. Should I start the topic?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. First of all, I would like to thank the President, Dr. Godhatwar sir, Secretary Vakshay sir, Dudmal sir, Acting President, ARN Coordinator, Dr. Kohli sir, Convener of the Academy of Rog Nidan, coordinated by Rog Nidan Department, APM's Ayurved College, Sion, Mumbai, for organizing this single lecture series. I thank the coordinators and the convener for giving me the opportunity for delivering today's lecture. The topic for today's lecture is Upadrav. Okay. Ayurved is an ancient science where Trisutra Ayurved is explained, that is, the hetus, which are the cause for the development of the disease, linga, that is the lakshanas, which are important from which the diagnosis can be taken up, and the aushadhis, that are the treatment parameters, which are explained here. With the help of this, the process of diagnosis or the disease formation, that is its diagnosis and treatment to be applied to the patient, can be understood. The topic for in Rog Nidan Vikruti Vignan, we come across the process of diagnosis, which is ruled by following the Rogi Pariksha Vidhi. By Rog Pariksha, how the disease is developed is ruled out by following the Nidan Panchak. Whereas the Rogi Pariksha deals with the process of formation of deals with the process of examination in the patient to confirm the diagnosis. The process of diagnosis begins when the patient consults the doctor and present with a set of complaints, that is the symptoms. The physicians narrows the possibility of the illness likely to account from the apparent symptoms by understanding the dosha, dushyas, strotas, their dushti, role of agni, Am Nirmiti and the Rog marks which are considered. Once the physician completes the diagnosis, he explains the prognosis, that is the Sadhya Sadhyatva of the disease to the patient, and advises a treatment plan which includes the therapy and follow-up. Proper diagnosis and treatment helps in destroying the root cause of the disease, that is Samprapti Vigatan and its reoccurrence. But when the disease is not treated properly, or if the treatment is not properly followed by the patient and Nidan Sevan is still continued, the same Nidans in the Vyakta Avastha of the disease causes formation of the Upadravas. Before starting the topic, let us first understand the development of the disease and the Upadravas. First, the three main hetus responsible for the development of the doshas, development of the disease, includes Asatmindriyartha Sanyog, which develops due to the improper co-relations of the five sense organs and their respective objects. Second is the Prajnaparad, that is intellectual mistakes done by the misunderstanding or ignorance of the patient, of the person. Kala, that is this, here the effect of climate, environment and seasons, their Atiyog or Mithyayog or Heenayog. Because of this, there are changes and the development of the disease, due to which three types of effects are seen, which are developing the other three effects are seen due to this, which is explained along with the Kriyakal in the chart, in the PPT. The first effect is the vitiation of doshas. Sevan of unhealthy and unsuitable food and activities bring about changes in the three doshas, causing vriddhi and kshay of it. One or more doshas undergo slight increase in the cheap sites. This causes accumulation. This accumulation produces mild symptoms in the form of ichcha or dvesh for certain food and activities. Thus, sanchay is the stage in which vriddhi of doshas take place in its own site. Second stage is seen the effect is on agni, that is agni mandyata develops. By the action of unhealthy food and by increase of the dosha, it causes manda agni in the body, which results in inadequate and delayed digestion of the food, leading to the development of am. After vitiation of the doshas, in the second Kriyakal, Prakop comes in action. The doshas further increase and spreads to many of its own sites elsewhere in the body and exhibit their symptom. Negligence of appropriate action leads to the next stage, that is the Prasar Avastha. The doshas moves out of the Koshta to the Shakha, being transported by the circulating Rasadhatu. Here, powerful symptoms obstruct person's activities. The third effect is the Khavaigunya to develop. The increased doshas, which were traveling all over the body, gets mixed with the circulating Rasadhatu, now tends to accumulate at certain places in the Dhatu. That is, Sthana Sanshray develops and brings about abnormalities there, especially in the Strutas. Now, there are four kinds of changes or abnormal changes which are developing in the Strutas, causing Strutodushti or Khavaigunya. That it is Atipravruti, that is increased function of Strutas takes place, Sangha or Rodha that we call, that is the obstruction or blockages, increased function and increase in the size of the Strutas develops. Third change which takes place is the Granthi Nirmiti. Formation of the new growths, thickening of the Strutas is seen. Fourth change which is taking up is the Vimayika Gamanam. Due to the obstruction of movement of doshas, caused due to the obstruction of the movement of doshas. The arm which was formed by the mandarini accumulates in the rasadhatu and brings about changes in it. The rasadhatu's normal tanutva changes to bahalatva, vishadatva to pichilatva, and normal praman is increased. This kind of samarasa circulates all over the body, which finds difficulty in entering the strutas, minute strutas. Samras blocks the strutas and accumulates outside the dhatu parmanu and makes the dhatu vriddhi. That is, there is increase in the size of tissues. Every dhatu has its own specific agni, which we called as dhatva agni. This dhatva agni may also become tikshna or manda, causing shay and vriddhi, which causes vaishamyata in the dhatu, that is, abnormalities develop in dhatus. This vitiated dosh and dushyas togetherly, when they form samurchana, takes place in the sthana sanchare avastha of the kriyakal, along with the development of the disease. This kriyakal is the stage of actual commencement of the disease, showing moderately severe symptoms, that is, purva rupas come in action. If we see, there are two types of purva rupas, vishishta and samanya. In vyakti sthan or in vyakti avastha, the stage is full of manifestation of the disease, that is, rog utpatti takes place in it. Typical symptoms and signs, that is, the rupa lakshanas develop, they vary in number and strength and causes many other factors. The diseases are given specific names based on the hetus, that is, is taken up, varna, chief complaints or chief symptoms, chief sign symptoms, organs affected. From this, the name of the disease is developed. After rog utpatti, in the bheda avastha, from this, the specific group of symptoms of disease, that is, the doshik differentiation of the vyadhi can be done. That is, whether it is vataj, pittaj or kafaj, it can be said. All the symptoms of differentiation differentiate the person from another. This is called as bheda. When suitable preventive and curative measures are not adopted in the vyakti stage, it gives rise to bheda avastha. Bheda avastha is the stage of differentiation of the types of disease. When we go for the differentiation of the disease, four to five points are taken into consideration. Whether the disease is cured, then it is called as vyadhi muktat or vyadhi muktata. That is, sadhyata of the disease is seen. When the disease tends to become chronic, it is called as dirgha kalanubandha. When the disease carries with it another vyadhi lakshana, it gives rise to upadrava. When the disease serves as a nidan or etiological factor for another disease, it is called as the nidan avitakar rog. Or the disease may serve as a disclosure of death by giving rise to the avishta lakshanas. Now we will start with the topic, which is upadrava. The nirukti of upadrava is upasamipe dravati iti upadrava, this which occurs near and gives along with the and goes along with the vyadhi, it is called as upadrava. Upadravas, the vyakhya which is mentioned is upadravastu khalu rog uttay kalajo rog ashrayo rog eva stula anurva rogat pascha jayat iti upadrava sognya. The upadrava is one which occurs in the cause of the disease, that is, ashrayabhut of the disease and some other ashrayabhut of the disease of other disease, that is, the first vyadhi which is developed, its prabhal arambik doshas is responsible for the formation of the other responsible for the development of other disease, that is the upadrava, due to which other than the vyadhi lakshanas, lakshanas develop, which we called as upadrava, that is in the rog uttay kalaja.
Hello, ma'am, are you changed slide?
No, sir, same is going on.
Vyadhi utpatti.
Okay.
Okay.
So, if we give an example in this, in case of this, if we give an example of Rudroga, due to Ati Ushna Guguanna, that is the hetus which are mentioned in our text, it is Ati Ushna Guguanna, Kashaya Tikta Asyata, Shram Abhigata Adhyashan Prasange, Sachintan Vega Vidharan, means these are the hetus which causes the development of the disease. Due to the hetu sevan, the dosh having undergone morbid increase vitiates the rasadhatu and localizes themselves in the hrudayasthan, causing pain. That is the formation of the hrudrog takes place. Here first appears the features of the disease, due to which the cause of imbalance of the dosha, and if the dosha vitiating still continues, then in the later phase, features of upadrava develops. That is, first rudrog develops and then the upadrava such as shwas comes in action. Second vyakhya for upadrava is rog arambak dosh prakop janya anya vikaraha upadrava. Here Madhav Nidan has explained upadrava as rog arambak. Upadrava is the morbid event which develops by the factors which are responsible for the manifestation of the main disease. It may be due to the excessive aggravation of dosha, means excessive aggravation of dosha is responsible for the development of the disease. Due to dosha prakopa, following apathya, that is consumption of mithya ahar vihar, abnormal diet, change in behavior and lifestyle practices causes vyadhi nirmiti. This causes if excess apathya is seven. If excess apathya seven is still carried out, if still the excess apathya sevan is still carried out, the same hetus, same doshas develops another vyadhi, that is secondary disease is superadded to the existing one. This is what we called as upadrava. If we go for the example here, pitta prakop develops rakta pitta upadrava. That is, due to the sevan of ushna tikshna ahar, it causes pitta prakop and causes jwar vyadhi. If the ahar sevan is still continued, then due to this, there is vitiation of rakta and pitta, causing upadravas such as rakta pitta vyadhi develops. In case of kafaj kas, in case of next example, when we are seeing, that is the kafaj penis, it causes kafaj kas. Here the kaf, that is the morbid, in case of kafaj penis, the morbid kaf is caused by vitiation of the kapha, hetus which include consumption of cold, sweet, sour or salty food, exposure to cold climate or cloudy atmosphere. This causes remains same for the upadravas also, if the consumption is carried out, then formation of if consumption is carried out in presence of the vyadhi, they may take part in the formation of kaphaj penis, worsening the vyadhi. Next, नेक्स्ट स्लाइड चेंज कर. नेक्स्ट व्याख्या फॉर उपद्रव इज तत्र उपसर्गिका ना उपसर्गिको नाम यह पूर्व उत्पन्न व्याधि जगन काल काल जातो व्याधि रूप सृजति स तन्मूल एव उपद्रव संज्ञा. हियर औपसर्गिक आचार्य सुश्रुत has mentioned the word aupasargik synonym to the upadrav as they have this as they are balwan and the dirgha kalanubandhi and the doshas develop from the vyadhi. It denotes that disease which manifests upon another disease is called as upadrav, and this manifestation is due to the same factors which are responsible for the manifestation of the main disease. मूल व्याधि प्रशमाधीनम प्रशमम तत् उपद्रवम. द फर्स्ट डेवलप व्याधि इज प्रधान इन स्वरूप, दैट इज एज इट हैज इट्स ओन दोष दुष्य सम्मोक्षना एंड संप्राप्ति. इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज स्वतंत्र, दैट इज इट इज ऑल्सो टर्म्ड एज अनुबंध्य. एंड द उपद्रव विच डेवलप्स ऑन द व्याधि इज अप्रधान और परतंत्र, दैट इज गौण इन स्वरूप. So it is called as anubandha, means the upadrav being pradhan is the pradhan, and the vyadhi is pradhan, and the upadrav is anubandha to it. Since the nidana bhut dosha begins being similar in both, if the treatment is given to the pradhan vyadhi, its upadrava will also be treated. Upadrav is the episode which develops after the manifestation of the main disease and subside by giving treatment to the main disease. Example, if we see, that is, as upadravas develop within the sphere of the samprapti, the disease, samprapti of the disease, so the therapeutic management is same for both. Example, in udar vyadhi, shota develops as upadrava. The line of treatment for udar vyadhi mentioned is virechana. It means if the chikitsa of virechan is given to the udar vyadhi, the vyadhi will subside, and along with it the shot which is developed is also going to subside. But sometimes the treatment required for the pradhan vyadhi and upadrava may be contradictory to each other, and the upadravas may be more serious. In such cases, immediate treatment should be given to the upadravas. That is, if we see the example of same vyadhi, that is in udar vyadhi, if atisa develops as an upadrava in such condition, and this atisa takes up the gambhir ashukari swarup, as it causes serious effect like severe dhatushay, that is depletion of the tissues is seen, rasashay, that is depletion of nutrition is there, and if the virechan treatment is continued in such situation, the condition of the patient will be more serious. Therefore, virechan chikitsa should be discontinued and measures should be adopted to control the atisar as the first priority. Here, stamban chikitsa should be carried out. When the upadravas are sometimes, another concept is that upadravas are sometimes somnya or sometimes prana ghatak in swarup. When tivra jwar, shwas, murcha, adman, raktapitta, if these types of vikar develops as upadrava, then immediate treatment should be carried out. There are next is the classification of the upadrava. Before that, if we see the synonyms of upadrava, it is considered as upadrava which gives rise or arises after development of the disease, and upasargik which is produced from the disease itself. If we go in the classification of the upadrava, we have there in the classification, Acharya Charak has mentioned two types of upadrava on the basis of the number as well as severity. That is the stool upadrava and anu upadrava. Stool upadrava is the one in which if the disease has more in number and severe complications and shows all its lakshanas, then it is called as stula upadrava. Example, in rajakshma, if rajakshma in case of kasa vyadhi and rudrog in case of shwasa vyadhi develops as upadrava, then they should be termed as balvan upadrava. As these vyadhis are mulata balvan, they are alpaswarup upadrava lakshanas are to be considered as balvan upadrava. When stula upadrava has powerful pathological effect, that is prabal dosha, it has more involvement of the dushyas and shows a balvan samprapti, that these are termed as powerful pathological effect and serious symptoms, then such upadrava should be treated as a case of medical emergency. Example, if pandu is developed in rakta pradhar, that is menorrhagic condition, the rakta dhatu in rakta pradhar, rakta dhatu is lost from the sharir causing panduta, and pandu when it comes it may produce its own complications like shotha, that is development of swelling, dorbalya, weakness of murcha, that is unconsciousness. Hence pandu should be treated with top priority as the upadrava shows all its lakshanas and may cause life threatening effect. One more example if we see is about the vrana vyadhi. In case of vrana vyadhi, various number of upadravas are mentioned, that is nearly about 16 upadravas are there. The upadravas being more in number and may show gambhir avastha, since large number of upadrava present, it leads to asadhyata of the disease. Second type of upadrava is the anu upadrava. If the disease having less in number and less severe complications and shows less lakshanas, it is known as anu upadrava. When upadrava present with mild pathology and mild symptoms, that is dosh and dushya involvement is less, such upadravas can be cured by treating the pradhan vyadhi. Example, in case of jwar or pratishyay, if kas develops as an upadrava, it is considered as anu, since the dosh and dushyas are related for the development of another disease. In case of trushna, jwar, moha, kshay, kas, shwas develop as anu upadrava. After classification of the vyadhi, classification of the upadravas, let Let us see the difference between Upadrav and Nidan Arthaka Rog. When we are seeing this, Upadrav is the complication of the disease developed after improper treatment of the disease, whereas Nidan Arthaka Rog are the those where one rog or the disease serves as etiology for the another. Upadravs are not considered as separate disease, whereas Nidan Arthaka Rog are considered as separate disease. Treatment is mainly given to the Vyadhi in case of Upadrav, and in severe cases, treatment can be given to the Upadrav alone when the Samprapti will be Prabhal of Balwan. In Nidan Arthaka Vyadhi, treatment is given to the Nidan Arthaka Rog only. If we see the difference between Upadrav and Vyadhi, why these differences are entitled over here means when we are finding out the Upadrava, it should be differentiated from another same types of diseases, or the how these Upadravas and the Vyadhi are different is to be noted. In Upadrava, the Upadrava depends on the Vyadhi for its manifestation, whereas the Vyadhi develops independently is mentioned. Upadravas does not have its own Nidan, Samprapti and Chikitsa. It depends upon the Vyadhi. Whereas in Vyadhi, it has its own Nidan, Samprapti and Chikitsa. For in Upadrava, the treatment, if it is given to the Mool Vyadhi, then the Upadravas also subside. Sometimes specific treatment is needed for the treatment of Upadrava. If the Upadrava is Balwan. In case of Vyadhi, the Vyadhi needs Vyadhi Pratyanik Chikitsa or Dosh Pratyanik Chikitsa, or sometimes both are applied for the treatment. Next is the difference between the Upadrav and Avishta. In case of Upadrav, Upadravas are developed at Rog Uttai Kalaja, that is after formation of the disease, whereas the Avishta, they are developed at any stage of the disease or without any disease. In Upadrav, one can predict the relation between the Dosh and Upadravas, whereas in Avishta, no relation between the Dosh and Avishta Lakshanas is seen. In case of Upadrav, Balwan Upadrav denotes the Asadhyata of the disease or Kashtasadhyata of the disease, whereas in Avishta, it denotes the death which is Asadhya in Swarup. Avishta always shows bad prognosis, prognostic sign when they appear in the patient. Upadravas are always in Purus Ashrit, that is present within the body or within the Sharir. Avishta, it is the Purus Ashrit and Purus Anashrit in both the terms. Means it can be seen within the body, or the person can feel the Avishta Lakshanas himself. Upadravas help in assessment of Sadhya Asadhyata, whereas the Avishta helps in assessment of the Ayuman or the lifespan of the patient. In case of Upadrav, treatment is given to the Mool Vyadhi, then it will pacify the Upadravas too. In Avishta, there is no treatment mentioned for it. Next, we will see the characteristics of Upadrava. Now, these are mentioned by Acharya Charak. According to him, Upadravas develops after the disease, that is Rog Uttai Kalaja. Second characteristic is it is considered as Rog Madhya Kalaja, that is they manifest in the course of the disease after actual symptoms develops. Upadrav is mentioned as Rog Ashray since it totally depends on the Rog or Vyadhi for its development. It is considered as Apradhan when compared with the Mool Vyadhi So the chikitsa to the mula vyadhi leads to the shaman of the upadravas. Now they generally subside. This upadrava generally subside once the main disease is cured. It modifies the course of the disease, leading to the worse condition. So upadrava should be treated immediately because due to the main disease, that is mula vyadhi, patient already becomes durbal. And if the upadrava develops in the patient, he further loses strength, which in turn makes upadrava more difficult to treat. Next, we will see the characteristics of upadrava. Next, we will see the importance of upadrava. Acharya Sushrut has mentioned that upadrava shows its effect in case of sadhya sadhitva of the vyadhi. Due to the development of upadrava, sukha sadhya vyadhi becomes kashta sadhya or asadhya. In case of shul, based on the doshas, if ek dosha shul comes in action or develops, it is called as sadhya. Sadhyata takes place. In case of dvidosha shul, kucha sadhyata can be seen. In tridoshaj or the when upadravatmak shul is seen, it is considered as asadhya. That is, with the upadrava, it should not be treated. Acharya Sushrut in Sutrasthan 33 Adhyay, Avagniya Adhyay, he has mentioned various vyadhis along with the upadravas. The presence of which vyadhi is denoted as asadhya. Secondly, in case of chikitsa, two types of chikitsa are given to the mula vyadhi, due to which the upadrava subsides. Example, if in case of pramehi vyadhi, that is in stula and balvan pramehi vyadhi, samshodhan chikitsa is advised. Sanshodhan karma is given. In case of khusha and durbal pramehi vyadhi, bruhan chikitsa, it is advised. In case of upadrav chikitsa is given to the vyadhi janit upadrava. Example, in case of prameha, when prameha pidika develops, the principle for prameha pidika is shastra karma, which is done after the sanshodhan and ropan karma in patient. According to Acharya Charak, if lakshana stay in the sharir for a longer duration or longer period, that is chir kalanubandhi, then they may be considered as upadrav too. Example, if we say in case of prameha, which is kapha pradhan tridosh janya vyadhi, various complications come in action. It may cause, chir kalanubandhi period, then development of diabetic retinopathy, neuropathy, diabetic neuropathy or diabetic nephropathy, these conditions come in action. Every disease do not develop upadrava. The diseases which are prone to develop upadrava are fixed. Let us see the list of diseases where upadravas develop. This are the list where upadravas is seen in various vyadhi. Example, in case of jwar, kas, murcha, aruchi, chardi, trishna, atisar, vidgraha, hikka, shwas, angabhed, these are the list of upadravas in case of jwara. Likewise, there are many vyadhis where upadravas are seen. Some vyadhi may have less number of upadravas, while some may have more number of upadravas. If we see the probable factors for the development of Upadrava. No separate etiological factors are available in the literature which determines the Upadrava as primary or secondary disease. Disease is directly related, but probable factors can be taken into consideration for the development of the same in patient. Here, if we see the probable factors for the development of Upadrava, first factor is the Nidan Sevan. That is, the Hetus play important role in the formation of disease. After development of the Vyadhi, if the Hetu Sevan is carried out, Upadravas can develop. So, strict Pathya Palan should be carried out to avoid the formation of the Upadravas. So, it will be advised to the patient to strictly follow the diet of Pathya, which is recommended by the physician. Second probable factor for development is the Dosh Prakop. Due to the Dosh Prakop, Samprapti comes in action. If hetus are avoided, shaman of the doshas can happen. Third factor, probable factor for development of Upadrava is the Agni. That is, Agni Vikruti causes development of diseases. As Sarva Rogapi, Manda Agni is considered as a probable factor. Am Nirmiti is another factor which causes development of the diseases. Overeating, adhesion, vidagdha jigna, this should be avoided, which breaks the samprapti of Agni Mandya. Fourth probable factor is for the development of Upadrava, she can be considered as Prakruti. Since every person has its own Prakruti, that is, everyone is different from each other. When doshas are vitiated and prakruti are different, the vyadhi can be going in sadhya avastha. But if the vitiated dosha and the person has the same prakruti, then the disease may become difficult to cure. In case of fifth probable factor, is the Vyadhi Asam Sharir. That means the person having less Vyadhi Shamatva, who is weak by nature, and the disease which is developed are in Balwan Swarup or Guru Swarup, then the diseases or the Upadravas which are developed will become difficult for curing it. Sixth probable factor is about the Desha. The place where the person lives, whether it is in the Anup climate, Jangal Pradesh, or Sadharan Dvesh, here, Vata, Pitta, Kapha, these all three doshas accordingly will get vitiated and causes disease formation. Next and the last one is the Kala. That is, whether there are changes developed due to the climatic changes or it is due to the episodes in the person, that is right from the birth, growth, his maturity or death, in the course of the time changes develop in the body giving rise to certain diseases. Keeping all this factor in mind, proper measures of Nidan Parivarjan should be adopted and advised. And lastly, coming to the end of the topic, we can conclude that Upadrava represents the stage which is more troublesome, more lethal if not identified in proper time. So proper identification should be carried out in examining the patient. Hetus and even slight changes in the lakshanas should be considered and cured in a proper time. Every early treatment of the disease, so that the application of the Hetu Ling and Aushadhi mentioned in the text can be applied properly. Early treatment of the disease itself prevent from the formation or development of the upadrava. I hope this short topic is well understood. Once again, I thank the coordinators, convener, members of the Academy of Rog Nidan, students, and all for all your cooperation. Thank you, one and all. Thank you.
Hello.
Hello.
Yes, Ganesh sir.
हाँ सर बोला. हेलो.
हाँ ठीक है. कंटिन्यू सर.
हो गया सर.
ओके. ओके. थैंक यू वेरी मच मैम.
थैंक यू सर.
डॉक्टर नैना विश्वकर्मा मैम, एचयूडी एंड प्रोफेसर फ्रॉम आर एलआरके गड़ी इंग्लिश कॉलेज एज अ well elaborated all the topic regarding the upadrava. She will explain the definition of the upadrava, how the disease is produced, generated, and what are the types of the upadrava, what are the synonyms of the upadrava, and what is the concept regarding the upadrava as per the Ayurveda. And he will explain that the charak mentioned the how the upadrava has some properties, mahatva, that is the mahatva and guna of the upadrava. Also he defined the vyadhi sankar concept. In short, all the concept regarding the upadrava he has really, actually this topic is just too much short in description. He well elaborated that concept of the upadrava and the importance of the upadrava in this lecture. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you.
I request the participant, if any having doubts regarding the upadrava, please raise your queries. If any inputs, yes, one.
The question I have, sir. Difference between one question is, ma'am, there difference between upadrava and udarka.
Now, upadrava is what is developed, which is developed within the disease, that is, it develops in the manifestation of the disease itself. Udar is one point where it remains, the symptoms remain after the disease formation or after the disease has been cured. These are the two points which are we have to take into consideration. That is, the after development of the disease and shaman of the disease itself, there certain things remain behind. In case of Kushta Vyadhi, if we see, there the Asti Vikruti develops and the Angabhanga Prakriya, that remains. That is, there is a deformity in the body seen. That is what we called as Udarika formation.
There is another one question. Shall we consider coexistence of Upadrava along with Pradhan Vyadhi as Vyadhi Sankar?
Existing of Upadrava with the?
Along with Pradhan Vyadhi as Vyadhi Sankar. Actually,
it is self-explanatory, I think.
Yes, yes. You can consider.
Yes. Vyadhi Uttar Kalaj jo hote hai Upadrava. So it can't be exist. Another question is, ma'am, there difference between Upadrava and Paratantra Vyadhi.
Upadrava and Paratantra. Upadrava is the one which develops from the Vyadhi. Paratantra is other than the Vyadhi which is developing.
Yes. Okay, I think nothing is in chat box now.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you very much, ma'am, elaborating such a small topic, very important yes, topic, because Upadrava and Udarka are explained for student point of view.
Yes,
3 marks or maximum 5 marks.
Yes, but sir. And even the topic being so small and in yes, short sir. Period, I have developed only that much points covered. So
But ma'am, very much essential topic for today.
Yes, sir.
As per modern medicine, there are no cure, but upadrava is many more.
Yes, sir.
So upadrava can be included as adverse side effects and concomitantly existing with the diseases also. So thank you very much, ma'am, for elaborating such a... किसी ने आज तक इसको टच नहीं किया था उपद्रव के लिए.
चिकित्सा ट्रीटमेंट पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू व्हेन ट्रीटमेंट इज गिवन एट दैट पॉइंट वेयर द क्यूर ट्रीटमेंट इज गोइंग इन अ प्रॉपर डायरेक्शन लक्षणास और दिस उपद्रव व्हिच कम्स इन एक्शन इट हेल्प्स इन द डायग्नोसिस ऑल्सो मीन्स इसमें से अपने को ये भी मिलता है कि उपद्रव अगर निर्माण हो रहा है तो उसमें व्याधि का प्रबलता मीन्स गुरु व्याधि वहां पे डेवलप हो रहा है उस वहां पे वो दर्शाता है वहां पे.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.